In this video, I will show you how to solve a complex series parallel circuit to find out a current through a resistor which is inside that complex structure. See, in the circuit I have to find the source current and the current through 80 ohm resistor for this circuit. See, 80 ohm is this resistor and I have to find out the current that is flowing through this 80 ohm resistor. I have to also find out the source current that is out from the source. Okay, with this kind of structure the circuit is looking complicated, therefore at first I will simplify this circuit by using so-called point method of simplifying circuit. Let's say this is our source terminal and this is our A terminal and this is our B terminal. This will be our B terminal, this will be our B terminal and this will be our B terminal. Our point will continue unless we encounter a resistor. See, I cannot go beyond this because I will encounter resistors. Okay, let's say this is our point C, so this will be our point C. Let's say this is our point D, this will be our point D. Therefore we have total 4 points. Let's say this is our A point, this is our C point, this is our D point and this is our B point. So this will be our A, this will be our C point, this will be our D point and this will be our B point. See, if I want to go from A to C, I will encounter a resistor of 5 ohm. So this is my 5 ohm resistor. After that, if I want to go from C to B, if I want to go from C to B, I will encounter this 50 ohm resistor. So if I continue my journey from C to B, you see that I will encounter a resistor of 15 ohm. So look here, from this point to this point, by this way I can go from C to B. So from this C to this B, I will encounter another resistor, 60 ohm. Let's say this is my another resistor of 60 ohm. So far I have drawn this 5 ohm, this 15 ohm and this 60 ohm. If I want to go from C to D, I will encounter a resistor of 12 ohm and from this C to B, I will encounter a resistor of 6 ohm. So if I elongate my C point from here to here, you see if this is our C point, from C to D, I will encounter this 12 ohm resistor. So now let me draw that. This will be our 12 ohm resistor and from this C to this D, I will encounter another resistor of 6 ohm. Let's say this is our D point, this is 12 ohm and this is 6 ohm. So I will cross this 6 ohm and this 12 ohm. Now from this D to this B, I will encounter a resistor of 20 ohm. See, if I elongate this, you will see from D to B, I will encounter a resistor of 20 ohm. So I will cross out this. From this D to this B, I will encounter another resistor of 80 ohm. Now from this A to B, I have to connect a voltage source of 40 volt. Therefore if I draw that circuit will be our simplified circuit, plus minus 40 volt. Now see, this circuit and this circuit is same, but this is a more simplified structure. If I show you the neat sketch of the circuit, our circuit will look like this. Okay, so this will be our simplified circuit. In this circuit I will have to calculate the total source current. Let's say I will denote that current with I1. See, up to this point this I1 will not divide. when this I1 gets into this point, it will have two portion. One will go in this direction and another will go in this direction. Let's say the current that is flowing through this path will be our I2, and the current that will be flowing through this path will be our I3. See, up to this point this I3 will remain intact. So here this I3 will divide into two portion, but at this point we will get this I3. Therefore this the current that will be flowing through this point to this point, up to this point, will be our I3. Now see, this I3 will divide into two portion. One will go through this 80 ohm and another will go through this 20 ohm. Let's say the current that will be flowing through this 80 ohm is I4. In this circuit I will have to calculate the total current I1 and the current that is flowing through our 80 ohm resistor I4. Now at first I have to calculate the source current I1. So if I want to calculate the source current I1, I have to calculate the total resistance with respect to this terminal and this terminal, and that resistance will be our total resistance of this circuit. So to calculate the total resistance RT with respect to that two terminals, at first I have to start my simplification from this right side. Now you will see, with respect to these two terminals, this 80 ohm and this 20 ohm resistor will be in parallel, and their equivalent parallel resistance I can calculate by using this formula, 80 into 20 divided by 80 plus 20, which will be equal to 16. That means I can replace these two resistance with 60 ohm single resistance. See, with respect to this terminal and this terminal, this 6 ohm and this 12 ohm resistors will be in parallel. I can also reduce this 6 ohm and this 12 ohm into a single resistor, and I will calculate their equivalent resistance using this formula, 6 into 12 divided by 6 plus 12. You know that when we have total two resistances connected in parallel, let's say R1 and R2, I can calculate the resistor between these two terminal, let's say RT, by using this formula, R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So 6 into 12 divided by 6 plus 12 will give us a value of 4 ohm. That means I will replace these two resistors with 4 ohm and these two resistors with 16 ohm. Now you will see, with respect to this terminal and this terminal, this 15 ohm and this 60 ohm resistors are connected in parallel, so I can replace them with a single resistor, and I will calculate that resistor equivalent resistance between these two terminal with this formula, 15 into 60 divided by 15 plus 60, which will be equal to 12 ohm. Now you will see, if I replace these two with 4 ohm and these two with 16 ohm, this 4 ohm and this 16 ohm resistors will be connected in series. That means I can replace the resistor between this terminal and this terminal. That means I can replace this branch resistor with a resistor of 20 ohm, and I can replace the resistors in this branch with a resistor of 12 ohm. Therefore our new circuit will look like this. I am calculating R equivalent with respect to this terminal and this terminal. Here you will see, with respect to this terminal and this terminal, this 12 ohm and this 20 ohm resistors are connected in parallel. I can replace this 12 ohm and this 20 ohm with a single resistor, and I will calculate that resistor using this formula, 20 into 12 divided by 12 plus 20, which will give us a value of 7.5 ohm, and that resistor will be connected in series with this 5 ohm. Therefore in this circuit I will get a total RT equal to 7.5 plus 5, which will be equal to 12.5 ohm. So our total resistor RT equal to 12.5 ohm, and here our supply voltage is 40 volt. Therefore our total current I1 will be equal to total supply voltage will be 40 volt, and total resistance will be 12.5 ohm. Therefore I will get I1 equal to 3.2 ampere, and this 3.2 ampere will be our total current. Now if I want to calculate the current that is flowing through this branch, that means the branch between this point to this point. If I want to calculate the current through this branch, or if I want to calculate the current through this branch, I have to reduce these all these resistors into a single resistor, and this branch resistor also into a single resistor. And previously I have shown you that these two resistors will be in parallel and their equivalent parallel resistor will be 60 ohm. These two resistors will be in parallel, their equivalent resistor will be 4 ohm. Therefore, this branch will have a resistor of 16 plus 4 equal to 20 ohm. As 15 ohm and 60 ohm are connected in parallel, their equivalent parallel resistor will be 12 ohm. That means I will represent this branch resistor with 12 ohm resistor and this branch resistor with 20 ohm resistor. So our I1 is equal to 3.2 ampere, and here I have replaced this branch resistor with 20 ohm and this branch resistor with 12 ohm. Now if I want to calculate the I3, I have to apply our special current divider rule. What is that? If I want to calculate the current through this 20 ohm, I will take the resistor of opposite branch, 12 ohm divided by the sum of 12 and 20 ohm. 12 divided by 12 plus 20 into total current that is entering at this terminal, that will be 3.2 ampere. Therefore, our I3 will be equal to 1.2 ampere. Now, look at this circuit. Here our I1 was 3.2. Our I3 was 1.2 ampere. Therefore, our I2 should be equal to 2 ampere. Now I will calculate this I4 that will be flowing through this 80 ohm resistor. The current that is entering at this point is equal to 1.2 ampere. If I want to calculate the current through this 80 ohm resistor, I will take the resistor of opposite branch. See, I4 will be equal to 20 divided by the sum of 20 and this 80. 20 divided by 80 plus 20 into the current that is entering at this point, that will be equal to into 1.2. therefore, I will get I4, the current that is flowing through this 80 ohm resistor, will be equal to 0.24 ampere. Now to validate my circuit analysis approach, I have set the circuit into multisim simulator. Now I will run the simulation and show you that total current will be equal to 3.2 ampere, and the current that will be flowing through our 80 ohm resistor will be equal to 0.24 ampere or 240 milliampere. Okay, see, this multimeter is showing the reading of 3.2 ampere, and this is our source current. I have deduced that after that this current that is flowing through this 80 ohm equal to 240 milliampere, which is equal to 0.24 ampere. Okay, that means my circuit analysis is completely okay. That's it. Thank you.